Hello everyone, today we are here to show you various equipments used in chain surveying, which has already been discussed in our theory class. We have ranging rod, a wooden cross staff with the stand, a metric chain, steel tape, a cloth tape and a fiber tape, wooden cross staff, head of the wooden cross staff, a arrow and pegs. First, we will discuss about metric chain. This chain is called as metric chain because it is in terms of meter. The designation of the chain will be given at the handle where the value of the chain will be written. It is shown over here, 30 meter chain. This is a 30 meter chain. We have two handles at either end of the chain, and the handles will be joined to the chain with a swivel joint. Swivel joint is nothing but you can rotate the chain handle in any direction without entangling the chain. Now, we have n number of links over here. Link is nothing but the distance between middle of one ring to the middle of next ring. This distance, this total distance will be considered as one link length. Now, each of these rods will be connected using three different rings. It is very clear in this that we have three different rings, and distance between middle ring to the distance of the next middle ring will be considered as one link length. This distance will either be 30 centimeters or 20 centimeters. To show you, we will extend a tape and show you the distance between two points. Here we can clearly see that the middle of this ring is at 20th denotion. And this is in terms of centimeter, from 20 centimeter to 40 centimeter. So this means the length of this one link will be 20 centimeters. And if you can clearly see, the first link is of shorter length. It is purposefully made shorter such that even the length of this handle is also taken into consideration. And the total length of the first link will be 20 centimeter from this groove up to this point. Next, after each 10 links, we will be having something called as thalis. That is nothing but to denote the number of links, which is 10 meters, 10 links, 20 links. This we have got a single teeth. This indicates first link. Here we have got two teeth. Two teeth indicates a second link. Next we have got three teeth. Three teeth indicates third link. And four teeth, which indicates fourth link. Next, at the fifth link, that is at 10 meters, we have got a round ring and a 10 meter is written on the brass ring. The same thing is repeated with the next 10 meters and the next 10 meters. So we will be having of two rings and all the components in two numbers. Next we have got steel tape. This is steel tape, and we also have got cloth tape. Extending the cloth tape, the designation of the tape will be given at this corner, and we have a handle at the starting of the tape. The length is included, the length of the handle is also included in the total length of the tape. It is pulled in this manner and it has designation on both the sides of the tape. On one side it is in metric units and on the other side it is in terms of feet. So while using tape, be careful to see which side you are reading so that you will clearly denote the meters or in terms of feet. Winding of the tape is done in this manner. To show you once again, the tape is unwound in this manner and rewound into the box in this manner. Make sure there are no dust on the tape before winding it up. Next, we have got arrows. These are called as specs and this is called as arrow. Arrow will be of around 40 to 50 centimeters height. We have got a sharp edge at one end so that it can be clearly driven into the ground. And on the other end, it is made into round to make sure it is carried easily, and also at points to put a tag indicating the name of the point at which the peg is being driven. Next, we have got wooden cross staff. This wooden cross staff is used to mark perpendiculars. How do we mark perpendiculars using this wooden cross staff? It is clearly shown that there is a plus mark on this wooden cross staff. One of the survey man will be standing at one end of the plus mark, and another person will be standing perpendicular to the previous person, and each one of them will be sighting a ranging rod placed at the end of this cross line. This will be indicated in the next video how to set out perpendicular to the line. Along with the stand, it looks like this. This is the stand with which we will be driving it inside the ground where perpendicular is to be set up, and perpendicular is set using this cross staff. Next, we have got ranging rod. Ranging rods are used to denote major station points on the ground. It has got a conical end which can be driven inside the ground, and it is made of cast iron or mild steel, and the entire length of the ranging rod will be made into number of bands. These alternate red and white, or black and white is the major colors used. The total length of the ranging rod will be 3 meters. Now, 3 or 2 meters, we get it in different lengths. It is either 2 meter, 3 meter or 5 meters also. 5 meters becomes difficult to handle, hence generally 3 meter or 2 meter is used. Each band is of 20 centimeter or 30 centimeter in height. This is made in particular to make sure, in case you do not have tape or chain to measure, this band length is used to find out the length approximately. Thank you.